Now, the parliament in Ankara has approved a government motion to deploy troops to Libya in support of the UN-recognized administration in Tripoli that's been fighting against the warlord Khalifa Haftar. Remember, it was his forces who launched that offensive to capture the capital last April. Turkey says its troops will protect its right in the Mediterranean and interests in Libya, like the deals that Ankara and Tripoli recently signed on military cooperation and maritime boundaries. But there were challenges. Turkish opposition parties were against the move. They say Ankara should have first given priority to a diplomatic solution. So let's start in Ankara. Mohammed Ado is our correspondent who's been following this one today. Mohammed, take us through the vote. How decisive was it?
Quite decisive, Kamal. 325 members of parliament voted for it, while 184 voted against. Of course, it is the voting power that the AK party and its affiliate party, the MHP, have in parliament that saw that motion sail through parliament. The opposition legislators were really heated in their opposition to it, saying that Turkey should not get sucked into the murky quagmire that the civil war in Libya is, saying that the country is yet to recover from its military interventions in neighboring Syria. And they have warned that there was a need for diplomatic avenues to be pursued first instead of putting Turkish boots on the ground in Libya. Of course, this is something that the AK Party leaders are not listening to. They have a plan, and it could be a matter of days, according to the defense ministry, which is the defense minister speaking, saying that they're ready to deploy as soon as possible. So there is some sort of the whole process was also fast-tracked with members of parliament being called in from recess a week early. So it looks as if Turkey is really itching to take its troops to Libya and as soon as possible.
And what does Turkey get out of this, Mohammed? I made a reference in the introduction there to shared interests in the region. Can you give us a little more detail?
Well, yes, Turkey has always said that it has a moral responsibility to help its neighbor to the sea, Libya, after an invitation by the government in Tripoli. But again, analysts are quick to point out that there are far greater interests at play here, and particularly the scramble for energy resources on the eastern part of the Mediterranean Sea, which at one point Turkey was lagging behind after Israel, Egypt, Cyprus and Greece signed an agreement for an exclusive economic zone and a pipeline that that would ship natural gas from the eastern Mediterranean Sea to Europe. Now, with that agreement, the maritime boundary agreement that Turkey has signed with Libya, it gives it a huge leeway and really increases its chances of also pursuing natural resources in the Mediterranean Sea, and also makes for the other camp quite difficult to wish Turkey away, because it will be controlling a huge part of the eastern Mediterranean Sea, and particularly because it has a very long coastline on the Mediterranean side. So knowing very well that if Haftar comes to power in Tripoli, given the advances he's been making in recent days and weeks, they know that deal will be off the table, and that is something Turkey is really keen to protect and see the continuation of the government of national accord staying in power in Tripoli.
Mohammed Ado in Ankara, thank you for all of those details. This conflict in Libya has many regional powers vying for influence. Turkey says it can help that UN-recognized government in Tripoli to fight off the warlord Khalifa Haftar and his advances. Remember, Haftar's stronghold is in the east, in Tobruk. Over the past few months, Russia has deployed fighters to assist Haftar's soldiers. The United Arab Emirates, Egypt, Saudi Arabia, France, they have lined up behind Haftar. The US publicly supports the government of National Accord in Tripoli, but President Donald Trump has praised Haftar in the past. And Qatar also backs the Tripoli government. Our senior political analyst, Marwan Bashara, with me here now. Marwan, as I listed off all those countries here, it's just reminding me, and Mohammed made the reference as well to Syria in the past, all these different players who all want their little slice of the action there, isn't it?
Absolutely. The problem with it is most of them are on the wrong side, meaning they claim publicly that they are for the internationally recognized government in Tripoli, while secretly, covertly, they are supporting the warlord that is attacking the internationally recognized government in Tripoli. And this is where the paradox lies. We have an internationally recognized, publicly declared support for a government.
Yes.
Covertly, even countries like France, that until today it says, we recognize the internationally recognized government in Tripoli, and yet they seem to be in all ways and means supportive of the drive against Tripoli. Mm. Certainly it is the case by the United Arab Emirates and Egypt. Now, the question is the United States? Because you mentioned the United States. Back in April, President Trump, out of nowhere, called Khalifa Haftar.
This is when he launched the offensive, absolutely, wasn't it? April, yeah.
And the United States was supposed to be in support of the government in Tripoli. So what happened? Well, something very simple happened. The day before, he was meeting with the Egyptian president, Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, and an hour or two before, he was talking to the crown prince in Abu Dhabi, right, in the United Arab Emirates. So clearly, the American president was convinced by regional leaders and by his national security advisor, John Bolton, to support Khalifa Haftar. But since then, things have changed. The United States today is taking a bit more hands-off, if you will, approach, not exactly in support of Haftar.
And so now that we have this vote in Turkey where the troops will be going, and how much of a game-changer is that? Because Turkey doesn't go into military action lightly, and it is a strong military force. How much does it change the game in Libya?
Absolutely. This is neither suicidal move on the part of Turkey, nor is it altruistic totally by Turkey. This is a strategic move that has three layers to it. A geopolitical move that looks at the Eastern Mediterranean and tries to see where it positions itself favorably, in this case, on the side of Libya, against another emerging trio, Greece, Israel, and Egypt. Second, militarily, it deploys in some form or another in support of Tripoli in order, and that's the third layer, to position itself at the table in Berlin, because if this deployment should mean anything, it's not to escalate the war, but rather to speed the process of negotiations.
Oh, my goodness. OK, Marwan Bashara, thank you so much for that. Marwan's our senior political analyst, of course.